हेलो डियर, आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर फाइन। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर सेकेंड। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मेथड्स ऑफ इंक्वायरी इन साइकोलॉजी। मीन टू से व्हाट टाइप ऑफ डेटा एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ मेथड वी यूज दैट द साइकोलॉजिस्ट ऑल्सो यूज टू क्रिएट सम टाइप ऑफ थ्योरीज एंड द प्रिंसिपल्स। बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग विद द चैप्टर वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट आफ्टर रीडिंग द चैप्टर विच थिंग वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट। फर्स्ट वन, वी विल understand that what are the goals should be there for inquiring any type of data and what is the nature of that data. After that we will understand that what different type of data we used or psychologists use to understand the different theories. Then we will analysis the data, and for analyzing the data what type of methods are used we will discuss also them. Then there are also some limitations in psychological inquiry that we will discuss in detail. Some ethical guidelines are also issued by the researchers. We will also discuss that when we are doing the research, then what type of things we should take care of. So let's move with the chapter. Psychologists use a variety of research methods because questions about human behavior are numerous and all of them cannot be studied by a single method. That's why there are so many methods such as observation, experimental, correlation research, survey, psychological testing, case study, and another. These all methods study the problems of the psychology that is related with the human behavior. In this chapter, you will familiarize with the nature of the information or data that we collect in psychological studies and some important issues also that are related with our testing. So in this chapter our first topic is goals of psychological inquiry, that if we are doing some type of research then what type of goal we should set for that and what will be the result of that goals. In this we include four goals. First one is description, second is explanation, control, and the last one is the application. We use this research by using scientific method. So our full study will be in an objective manner. Objective mean to say we use scientific method and we have some standards to pursue with our study. In description, the psychologist or the researcher want to describe the behavior of the person so that he can differentiate between the one particular behavior from the another person's behavior. For example, how we are able to understand the behavior of the person? Suppose if one researcher or the psychologist is interested in observing the study habits. Here the title of the research will be the study habits among the student. So what the researcher will do for that? He will try to understand the different students' behavior and how they are attending the classes, how they are doing their daily work, are they following some type of timetable, they are submitting the assignments on time or not. So all these are the things that he will try to understand individually. After that he will describe all these things. Here there is not only a thing that the researcher is observing, he will also describe the each habit of the child. After that there is a recording of particular behavior is also necessary so that the researcher can understand the proper understanding of the each student behavior, that why this behavior is different from the another student behavior. That's why the heading of this topic is description. Our next one is the prediction. As the name suggests, prediction means to say when we try to say something on the basis of present thing about the future. This is the second goal of our scientific inquiry. If the researcher is able to understand or describe the particular behavior of the child accurately, or he is able to differentiate between the behaviors from one student to the another students, then on the basis of present situation, researcher can forecast that this particular behavior that the child is showing will be the outcome of this child in the future. For example, if one child is devoting his time mostly on his studies, and then we can say that this child will get good marks in the examination. Our next one is the explanation. This is the third goal of our psychological inquiry. In this, psychologists are mainly concerned that what are the causes and what are the factors by which the individuals are behaved differently and why that things happen to the person, that it caused the person to behave different in a different circumstances. In this we can take the example, like two siblings are there. If one child is going school properly and the child attendance is very good, on the other hand, the same child's brother or sister is not able to attend the school on daily basis. So the researcher will be interested that what are the reasons and what are the causes or factors that is making the child not to attend the school, and what are the reasons or the causes for the other child that make the child to be more attentive. So behind all these things, the researcher is interested to know the cause-effect relationship between the two variables. Our next one is control. In this, we try to control one particular behavior in which we want some changes. It can possible only if we are able to understand that what are the factors and the causes behind that behavior. Then we try to control that antecedent conditions. Antecedent conditions are those conditions which cause or which make the person or the child to behave in a particular conditions. For like during the summer days, we prefer to remain in cool areas because of the hotness. So here the antecedent conditions are the hotness that is in our environment. So here control refers to the three things. First one is making a particular behavior happen. For this we can reduce it also, and for this we can enhance it also. If we want that child should be good in science subject, then we can enhance the timing hours for the study of the child's in the timetable for the science subject particularly. This change is not possible to bring at once. It needs time. The change mainly brought in the behavior by the psychological treatment. If we will talk at a grand level in terms of therapy, our last goal is the application. The final goal of the scientific inquiry is to bring out the positive change in the life of the people. Psychological research always conduct this type of inquiry so that they can solve the problems in various settings, and by this they can make the efforts to improve the quality of life of the people. This is a major concern of the researchers. Our next topic is steps in conducting scientific research. We cannot define science only by saying that what type of investigation it include and how it investigate the things. Scientific method attempt to study a particular event in an objective, systematic and testable manner, so that whenever another person will try to test the same thing or research on the same thing, the conclusion will be the same. It may differ because of the cause and effect reason. Now under this, our first one is the objectivity. Objectivity refers to the fact that if two or more persons independently study a particular event, then both of them at a great extent will arrive at the same conclusion. For this, there is one example, like if you and your friend measure the length of a table using the same measuring device, then the result should be same. Our next one is the systematic procedure that we use in a scientific research. There are some steps under this which involve conceptualization of a problem, collection of data, drawing conclusion and revising research conclusions and theory. Under this, firstly we will discuss about the conceptualization of problem. Conceptualizing a problem means to say, before starting a research on anything, we should understand the things that on which part or on which theme we are going to do study and what we want to know about thing. For this, firstly we select the theme or topic for the study, and after that we try to narrow down that on which part we want to do more focus. Like if we have decided the behavior of the person, so which type of person, whether you are going to take the person at the infancy age or childhood age or adulthood age, so there are so many dimensions, so we have to narrow down the facts. After that, we develop some specific research questions or problem for our study. That questions that you want to get answer after your study. This is done on the basis of the review of the past research. Whenever you are going to select one research or theme that you want to do research on that particular topic, maybe it is possible that the same topic was researched by the another person. So you should take the review of that past research, and you make your observation and personal experiences. Under this, the example is given that here we have read that researcher was interested in observing the study habits of the student. For this purpose, if we use this in a scientific method, then firstly we will try to identify the different habits of the child, after that we will decide that whether they are interested in doing the study at home or only in school. So there is a diverse range of problems that are related with the behavior and our experience that we study in psychology. These problems we try to understand relating with our own behavior. How do I feel or behave when I am in a state of joy or grief? This is the question, this is the problem that we want to get the answer related to our behavior. And another thing, that when we try to understand the other individual's behavior, that why is someone not able to complete his or her work on time? These are the thing that is related with the another person's behavior. Next one is the group influence on the individual behavior. Like if you are having your group, we can say, then what type of the effect or what type of the influence your peer group have on you? We study also that topics. And group behavior. In the group behavior, we try to understand that when the persons are in a group, then why they are able to take risk at a very high level. Like when you feel the company of your friend, then you feel more secure, then why it happens? These all the things. And why some are the organizations are very successful, on the other hand the another organizations are not at that level. So all these are the things, all these are the range of the psychological problem that we include in our research. After identification of the problem, when we know that our theme will be this and we have selected this problem, then we try to develop a tentative answer of the problem. Like example, based on the earlier evidence or the observation, you might develop a hypothesis that greater is the amount of time spent by children in viewing violence on television, higher is the degree of aggression displaying by them. Because the child is observing that things, the child will grab that things very easily. So we can make this one hypothesis. In research, maybe your this statement can prove true or false. Our next one is the collection of data. This is the second step in scientific research. Data collection require one blueprint. We can develop one type of blueprint for the entire study. So in this we require taking decisions about four aspects that are, first one is that what type of participants will be in our study and what type of method we will use for our data collection, and if we are using some particular methods, then which type of tools we are using for that research and how we will proceed with the data collection. These all things in the data collection depend on the nature of the study also and the researcher also, who is going to decide that what type of participants will participate in his research, like whether he is going to choose the children, adolescents or college students or teachers. So it also depend on the researcher. After that, second decision is related to the use of method of data collection, that what type of method the researcher is going to use, whether he is using observation method or experimental method. So many methods are there. This is totally depend on the researcher part. Next decision will be related to the using of appropriate tools, that what type of tools he is going to use. All these things we will study in detail, whether he is preferring interview, observation or questionnaire. Then our last one is to that how the researcher is going to administrate that tools, whether he want to administrate the tools only on the individual or to the group also. So all these things include in the collection of data. Our next step is drawing conclusion. This, after collecting the data, we try to analyze the data so that we can come to know about the result. For analyzing the data, we use some type of statistical procedures. We are applying scientific study here. For this, we can use graphical representation also, bar diagram, all the other things that are related with the statistical methods. In this also, we try to verify the hypothesis and we try to come to the conclusion. Our next step is revising research conclusion. When we come to know about the conclusion of our data and we have analyzed our data, then we try to understand that which hypothesis we have created at early stage, that is relation between viewing violence or television and aggression among children. After collecting all the things and after analyzing the things, we try to understand that hypothesis that we have prepared, is that true or false? If the hypothesis created by us in the starting, if that hypothesis is true, according to our research by using the statistical technique, then we will develop one theory that yes, if the child is viewing the television and the child is viewing the violence on the television, then it also inculcates the aggression in the child. If it is not supporting our hypothesis, then we can alternate our hypothesis, or we can alternate our theory, or we can develop a new theory on the basis of the present data and the conclusion, which may be verified by the future research. Like this research is a continuous process. So that's all for this video. In our next video, we will move with the next topics. Till the time, try to understand this chapter and this topic thoroughly by reading. Thank you.